Hey guys, PeterGregg, Miami, Florida. This is the hot camera.
Yep.
The Nikon. This is a world famous, global famous YouTuber. And he just popped in with his son, who's back there. You're going to hear him on the piano. Oh, you can see his head. Yeah. Cool. So the piano has got him distracted. Okay. And we're playing footsies down here, but don't worry about it. All right. So how you doing?
I'm doing good.
I haven't seen you in a long time.
Yes. Time flies.
And you went to another country and came back.
Yeah, called Hollywood.
Hollywood.
Yes.
All the way up there. So you participated in that conference that they had up there, and I hope you had a good time.
No, it was amazing.
I heard Aiden was one of the hits.
He's the hit.
Every time, right?
Yeah, well, when it comes to it, they make the reservations for him, and I'm his plus one.
Oh, you're his plus one.
Yeah, so I just get to tag along.
So we decided we're going to sit in front of the camera just for a few minutes and say hi to everybody, because you all know both of us. It's all part of the family, okay? So we're running a Nikon Z6 Mark III. I've got a 50 millimeter lens?
Yes.
And you saw it. What is it? One take, 1.8, right?
Yes, 51.8 from, how do you say it, Makey?
Oh, Makey. Yeah, I wrote to them because I keep saying Mikey.
Yeah, I would always say that
natural.
As well.
Mikey. Yeah. You but know, Makey. from the cereal.
So now try to reprogram
Let
that.
Let Mikey try it. So we got the Makey lens, or Mikey for the most of you that know what it how it's pronounced.
It looks good.
And he just came back from an eCam conference.
Yeah, the Creator Camp.
And he drove up there with Aiden and came back just a couple of days ago, right?
Yeah, what's today? Well, just last weekend, so yeah.
Would it be putting you on the spot to say what were, like, highlights, or...?
No, not at all. Well, it was actually the last day of the event, where actually not of the event, of my trip over there, that I met up with Lori, and she gave me the word that, like, encompassed the entire event for me, which was serendipitous.
Serendipitous.
Yes, like everything fell into place perfectly. If you say the stars aligned, well, they were aligned the entire time. So many things were just happening back to back to back, like dominoes falling.
So it worked out really well.
It was probably the best 2 weeks.
Were the boys there?
Which boys?
The twins.
Oh, of course. They were there hanging out. That's some of those special nuggets. Let's see what Aiden wants.
We'll pause. All right, we're back. We took our Aiden break. And Aiden got a little gift. We got him a kazoo. Mm-hmm. And he was deathly afraid of it. He held his ears. I didn't record any of it because kind of private moment, okay? But you never know what a child's going to react to. So he does not like the sound of the kazoo. Plus, Lewis said he's going to have to teach him how to work the darn thing. You know, because for a while I used to blow in it, mm-hmm. and does nothing. You gotta, excuse me, hum. All right, we were talking about the trip up north.
Oh, yes.
And his trip down south to the PeterGregg Christmas room. So he's full of trips. It's all over the place.
Mm-hmm. It's been nonstop. October has been a very busy month.
It's been a busy month.
But okay, in a good way. So.
Yep, I gotta find a spot for my elbow. So it is a little tight. I'll have to remember that, so when I have guests and stuff, because I normally do a standing, and then I got lazy and I decided I'm going to sit. So I got a little table. I've got the mic, which is a Shure, or whatever it is, SM57, and we're both on the same microphone. So we're just kind of playing around, and he's visiting. Randy's camera, he's taking it with him, and he's going to use Randy's camera. And he's dropping off one of Randy's other cameras, which is a Canon
R10.
Okay, so you'll be seeing me pop up with some R10 and stuff. Mm-hmm. So, any story you want to tell about the trip, or we're gonna close this out.
Oh, yeah. Well, I was saying that everything was serendipitous, right?
But it fell together well.
You were asking me if the twins were there. And I was going to say that, yes, that's actually like one of those highlight moments for myself, which is, you know, Ken and Glenn, they're just amazing. And they also have the same affection and love and care towards Aiden.
They got children, right? They're on.
I believe one of them do.
One of them has, okay.
But I could be mistaken, you know, we just have...
Well, I know one of them has children. They've shown it. I just didn't know which one it was, so...
But at the same time, it was Ken who just was taking his time off while there was one of the speakers, and he's off to the side just playing with Aiden with the magnets, you know, just...
Really?
Because it's, you know, like, while he's listening to Ken? The event. Yes. Like, so I then turned the camera and started recording that just for myself. You understand? It's just one of those memories for me. So there was so many of those types of moments because the eCamp fam and the community at Creator Camp, they do show so much love, not only to myself, but mostly towards Aiden. And there was another creator there who now became his new adopted aunt.
Oh,
you understand?
Wow.
Because she just asked me, she's like, can I be his adopted aunt? I'm like, of course. Like, if you want to show love towards my child, like, that's the best gift that could be given. And I think he deserves all of it, so...
Oh, we don't see him. Okay. He's having a ball back there.
Oh, they could probably hear it.
They can hear it. That's true. So when I put this in Final Cut Pro, and if I run voice isolation, I wonder if it'll take that out or not. I'm just curious.
Well, let's see.
Yeah, we'll find out.
And talking about that, did you hear the little excerpt from the new video coming from Apple?
No.
So have you heard of the new Mac Minis that are coming
out? Yeah, the new smaller one.
Exactly, the new smaller one. Well, in the video when they were showing or, you know, presenting the Mac Mini, they also referenced the new AI that's going to be working with it, the Apple Intelligence, and also the new Final Cut Pro that's going to be coming out in cahoots with this new AI.
That's so good news.
Apple Intelligence with Final Cut Pro in a new version.
I hope they update Logic Pro eventually.
That's another one.
Because Logic Pro is missing 32-bit floating, whatever it's called.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Okay. You know what that is?
Yeah.
Can I just tell them what it is?
Absolutely.
All right. So a 32-bit float is one of the choices because you can pick 24... this is the resolution of an audio, okay, the equivalent of resolution. So 32-bit makes it so it's very hard to actually over-modulate. You know when it's loud and it sounds fuzzy, like you're talking through a kazoo? So 32-bit float is supposed to fix that. And Rode is just came out with a microphone.
That has it built in.
Right. Which one is it? It's the NT1 fifth generation.
I think so.
Okay.
And their wireless pro one that connects, which
that
is
has
like,
32-bit float?
Yes.
Okay. So 32-bit float is interesting for somebody that likes to sing and belt it out. I keep my eye on him because last time he came, he fell off the piano bench and that totally freaked me out. Okay.
And he was fine.
And but, he's completely fine.
But he took more, you know, like
I overreact
trauma
a lot of
to the whole event than
I overreact. Than Aiden. You know. Just part of being Peter.
But here's another way of looking at the 32-bit float. Because I don't look at it as resolution. I look at it more in the photography terms as dynamic range.
That would be good.
So
that
you see the dynamic range is like how much color or light you're able to capture. And when you can expand the dynamic range, you have more colors or more light to play with. The audio works in a similar way. And the 32-bit float gives you the entire spectrum pretty much. Where even if you have things that would normally clip, meaning they've reached such a high note where, like Peter was saying, it sounds distorted and the audio or the digital audio can't reach those frequencies, with the 32-bit float, you'll be able to recover that and actually have a usable file without clipping, or even things that are very low, you'd also be able to bring them back up to use them. So
that's pretty cool. See, he came to fine-tune me. I get fine-tuned every year or two. So he comes and he fine-tunes. He's very electronic. He can fix the phone. He can fix all kinds of things. He can even fix a PeterGregg. So that's excellent. Awesome. I joke a lot. Poor Lewis has got to put up with me.
This is all part of it. I'm over here having a blast. Like, I'm looking at all this stuff and still just soaking
in everything.
Well, I used
to have,
everything.
There was a fourth camera over there. Mm-hmm. Can you find where it went? Up. Very good.
Oh man, that's a nice setup.
Yeah, I put up the first one and it was wobbly and it made me nervous. You don't want a camera
exactly
coming down. Okay, so I redid it and now it's on a small rig ball head.
Nice.
Okay, and the only thing not professional about it, Sly, close your ears 1 second, okay, is the cables are running across the room and dropping down. She's crazy on cables, okay? Mm-hmm. She came here and made me straighten out all the cables, and I completely unstraightened them.
Because it doesn't seem like she made you do it.
No.
Whatever you did was been undone.
It kind of like wore out after a period of time. Mm-hmm. So that's about it, guys. Just wanted to show you that Lewis came. We're exchanging cameras, and they're both Randy's cameras, so you guys know.
And stories.
And stories.
Tips and tricks, and we're exchanging
Aiden,
all this stuff.
I get to play with Aiden for a while,
yes.
And that is cool. And Aiden is not interested in me at all. There's this big brown thing over there, okay? And you see him? Right?
Look at him.
He's right over there. That's Aiden. Aiden, can you hear me? Ruff, ruff.
No, he's not even responding to his name right now.
No, he's what did you say? He's tuned into the notes or something.
Right now he's taking advantage because everything that I have is digital, even the keyboard. So he knows those notes, but now he's getting the real thing from the piano.
So when you're live, mm-hmm. Where is Aiden? Because I see you bend down to pick him up. Is he in a pen? Is he loose in the house?
He's just there, loose in the house.
Well, see, like, we don't know this. I'm wondering, where the heck is he?
If you were to see the live stream that I did, one of my last ones at a hotel room.
Right.
From the creator camp, you will see that, like, he's just rolling around doing his thing. So even though I was doing the live stream.
How do you keep an eye on him with the house? You have it, like, baby-proofed and stuff?
Yeah. Okay. I basically have it set up so that, like, he can only get to his things.
Okay.
And the way that I've set it up, and I've explained it a couple of times on my live stream, is that we split the space, but not, like, 50-50. We split the space 50-50. So everything from here
okay.
up belongs to me. That's why everything's, like, on shelves, is hung up, including all my lights.
Is he walking yet?
Just like not really, like he's not walking on his own, but he walks with assistance, with me holding his hands all the time, and I'm constantly getting him to work on that.
Do you think he will get to walk?
Oh yeah, okay. He's already standing by himself now, because before he would always do it with assistance,
right?
And now he's just like balancing himself on two legs and understanding what that's about, and that's the next step that we need to get, and then work those muscles so that then he just continues to understand that it's working out the balance, because most people think that walking is actually like something that you're doing, when it's actually something that you're preventing to do, because walking is actually your feet just catching you from falling. So okay. You're just falling forward,
you're
and your
falling
feet,
forward, and you're
and
walking.
And your feet are catching you from like falling on your face. So
as
that's
I'm getting
what
older,
is.
I'm losing balance a lot more easy. I noticed that. So
he has the balance, the equilibrium, and stuff is what we're still working on, and the muscles to actually have him do it. But right now he stands. He definitely moves around. You saw him get up and down on the chair.
I was shocked.
Exactly, but like he definitely is mobile. He does his things. He's just fine-tuning those final things to get him to start walking, and that's when I'm gonna have a blast to be able to just hold his hand and walk somewhere.
Right.
You know, so.
All right, guys. So this is the Peter and Lewis show, or and from Lewis's point of view, it's the Lewis and Peter show. I'm so glad that he came to visit, and I wanted you guys to see that family does come here. So now he's going to go play with the camera that he's taken home, and I'm going to play with the camera that
I'm going to play with the other ones around here.
Oh, he's going to play with all the cameras.
I got all the time in the world with the one that I'm taking home, so.
All right, guys. We both, we love you. Take care. Bye-bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.